Anderson Cooper, AC360, CNN weeknights 10 Eastern.
You were in charge of what was essentially an undercover operation that led to Greaves' arrest. You're in Florida. How did your office get involved in this in the first place? He lives in Colorado, has no real connection to the state of Florida.
Well, we watched Anderson Cooper on CNN and other national broadcasts, and people sitting around wringing their hands saying there's nothing we can do, free speech, free speech. This has absolutely nothing to do with free speech and everything to do with obscenity. We had a law in Florida that applied. We only needed jurisdiction. We consulted our state attorney's office, Brad Copley, and our state attorney, Jerry Hill. They said, if you can get jurisdiction, bring us a case. My detectives did a fantastic job, and that's what we did. We took them an autographed book that Phillip sent to us. That gave us jurisdiction. A circuit judge gave us a warrant, and the rest is history. He's in jail.
Now, police in Colorado, just to be clear, Sheriff, did investigate Greaves last month after the story came out, but found that he wasn't violating Colorado law. So how does that work? Is it because of the Internet and its impact on the entire world?
Well, the Internet has made everything a local event. And what our law says is you can't sit in Colorado and violate Florida law any more than you can sit in Florida and violate Florida law. When he transmitted, when he sold, when he delivered that book to us in Polk County, Florida, he violated Florida law, and that's why we were able to put him in jail. And the Pueblo police were fantastic in assisting us in this investigation.
Let me bring in Jeffrey Toobin here. I alluded to this, Jeffrey, but what about the First Amendment here? I mean, this is distasteful, Jeff. You have kids. I have three daughters. I mean, it's just terribly distasteful stuff. But could Greaves still claim protection under freedom of speech?
Well, you're certainly right that it's repulsive and awful, but I don't see how this prosecution can go forward because I think this book is clearly protected by the First Amendment. The Supreme Court dealt with a case very similar to this in 2002, where there was a federal law that said any sort of depictions of child pornography, including cartoons, are unlawful. And the Supreme Court said that was unconstitutional because the only kind of kiddie porn that can be prohibited is actual depictions of actual sex involving children. This book, as awful as it is only words. As you said, it is mostly two fictional stories about pedophilia, and that, I think, is a statement of opinion. It is a statement of a kind of art, and it is not constitutional to arrest him for engaging in that kind of speech.
Let me ask about one more thing that's come up, Jeff. So you heard the story from the sheriff there. Undercover detectives were involved. They solicited the materials from Greaves, and then they brought him back to Florida. Could any of this in any way be considered entrapment?
I don't think so. I mean, I think this is clearly a legitimate law enforcement investigation. And if, for example, Greaves had mailed to the detectives actual photographs of children having sex, I think this prosecution would be more than justified. But so I don't think there's any problem with what the detectives did. I think this law is too broad under the First Amendment, and I think it brings in material, distasteful though it is, that is protected under our Constitution.
Sheriff Judd, I mean, there's a lot of distasteful material out there. I mean, I was just going to the Amazon website today. There's books like Diary of a Pedophile, Fun with Pedophiles. There's lots of books out there that, you know, people could be concerned about based on what you're saying. I mean, what do you do about books like that? How does this all stay consistent in your own mind?
Well, it's consistent with us because he mailed this book to us. It was a how-to book of how to sexually abuse children, and it was a depiction in writing. Therefore, it's clearly a violation of Florida law. And quite frankly, the problem is, as our attorney just said, there's too much hand-wringing across this nation. When we can't stand together as a nation and say, you can't write a book and depict real-time stories, real stories of children being sexually abused, then it's time to change the law. Because you cannot sexually abuse children and write about it in a book. That's illegal, and that's why he's in jail.
Jeff, it wasn't a fiction book. I mean, there was at least a couple of real-life accounts, Jeff.
But that's still, it's words, it's stories, as the sheriff said, and stories are not illegal. in this country. You know, the reason we have kiddie porn laws is because the very act of taking a photograph of a children engaged in sex is a crime, because a crime is taking place. You need a crime to take a picture of it. For children's pornography. This is just words. We have no way of knowing whether anything in this book is true. We don't have police investigate whether stories that people write in books are true. As awful as this is, the core of the First Amendment is about protection of speech that, even though many of us, certainly including me, find it repulsive.
Sure. If you want to react to that, I mean, again, I think no one's disagreeing just how repugnant the material is. The question, though, I mean, you're saying the law should be changed. Obviously, Jeffrey talked about the fact that it does seem to be protected to some extent under freedom of speech.
Well, it's absolutely not protected under Florida law. You don't have to have a photograph. And, you know, our lawyer friend is still calling it kiddie porn. That is offensive to all the children that are victims of child sex in this country. It is real children being really abused, and he's telling a story about it. And it's harmful to minors, and it's clearly a violation of Florida law. And quite frankly, that's what we have the appellate courts for. But I can tell you this, if you mail materials to Polk County that are injurious to our children or encouraging them to others to commit crimes against our children, sexual crimes, we're going to investigate you and arrest you. And I believe that I can take this case to any jury in any state in this nation and clearly convict Phillip, because his conduct is outrageous and it is illegal according to Florida law. So stay tuned.
All right. Sheriff. Well,
Sanjay, if I could just jump in just real quick. I certainly, the sheriff and I disagree about the constitutional issue here, but I certainly agree with him that the issue of child pornography, what I called kiddie porn, is a very serious one, and I'm certainly glad that law enforcement is taking an active stand against it.